Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to get lithium metal. Our source is these Energizer Ultimate Lithium batteries. Regular batteries do not have lithium and cannot be used. Alright, our first task is to remove the plastic label and expose the steel casing. Once that's done, put on some gloves for the rest of the procedure, since the chemicals in the battery aren't exactly healthy. Now, the only tool you'll need is a pair of needle-nose pliers. Okay, the whole outer container here is the negative terminal, and the inner cap here is the positive terminal. The two terminals are separated by an inner lining of plastic. Use the pliers to squeeze and rip out the inner cap. It's very easy to accidentally short out the battery while you do this, so be careful. If at any point the battery starts to heat up really hot, then you've shorted it out and should immediately throw the battery outside before it starts venting its electrolyte. Do not retrieve and dispose of the battery until it's cooled down. Okay, we're just about done here, and there's the inner cap. Alright, now we have to separate the spacer and the release valve from the battery. To do this, peel the outer casing away from the inner components. Be careful, as it's easy to accidentally short out the battery. Dead batteries and shorted batteries will have lower quality lithium than brand new batteries, so it's best to avoid both. Alright, there's the spacer. Now we just need to get out the release valve. This valve exists to hold the electrolyte in, but will release the electrolyte if the internal pressure gets too high. This is to prevent a catastrophic failure, like an explosion, if the battery gets shorted or overheated. Okay, we're at the valve now. And here it is. Now we've exposed the core of the battery. Continue peeling and ripping away the casing to get at the top of the battery. This little thing is built like a fortress, so expect some frustrating manual labor to peel the casing. Be patient and don't let the casing touch the exposed top of the core, or the battery will short out. Finally, we've peeled away all the upper casing. Now, just pull out the core. And there it is. I'm going to go over to the fume hood to do the rest of the video, since this core is where all the chemicals are. Here is the core. Now just start peeling it away like a roll of tape. First, the outer protection. Now we unroll the core. This foil covered in black iron disulfide serves as the cathode, and since we don't need it, we'll just throw it away. Now we peel the separator to reveal our lithium metal. It will quickly start reacting with air, so work fast. And there we have it, lithium metal. Just fold it up and store it in a very tightly sealed container. Already, you can see it start tarnishing from the air. Okay, now one test for lithium is to just add a small piece to water. As you can see, it's highly reactive and releases hydrogen gas. The second test is simply to burn it. You can see in just the few minutes I've had it, it's already severely tarnished due to its reaction with air. Anyway, to burn it, just set it on fire with a torch. The camera does not do this reaction justice. In real life, it was so intense that I could not look directly at it. It was like looking into the sun. This little piece was so bright that it lit up the entire lab. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, rate, and comment.